Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Fallout 3. My name is Josh Jepson, but you knew that already. In the previous episode, we escaped the vault, and in this episode, we've made our way to Megaton. Hey there, guy.
Have yourself a nice visit, partner.
Thank you so much, Deputy Weld. Anyway, here we are at Megaton. We're trying to find our dad, but we're making a pit stop here at Megaton. I'm sure there's plenty to do here.
You're from that vault, Vault 101. I ain't seen one of those jumpsuits in a long time. Name's Lucas Sims, town sheriff, and mayor too, when the need arises. I don't know why, but I like you, boy. Something tells me you're all right. So welcome to Megaton. Just holler if you need something.
If I was playing an evil character and you said that, I would be laughing maniacally right now. nice time you got there, Sheriff. It's a pleasure to meet you.
Friendly and well-mannered. I think we're gonna get along just fine. You treat my people nice, and you're welcome to stay as long as you'd like.
Cool beans. Right. Message received.
I'm glad we understand each other. Now, is there something I can help you with?
I'm looking for my father. Is that why we're here? I mean, really, I know I'm looking for my father, but I want to know about the town.
What do you want to know?
Why is it called Megaton?
The town's named after the bomb that's sitting in the middle of it. It hasn't gone off yet.
Why are we here then? Do you think someone should disarm the thing?
I don't trust any of the locals to tinker with it. Besides, most people don't even realize it's still a threat. And hell, Cromwell and those crazies from the Church of Adam, they worship the damn thing. Why? You think you got the know-how to disarm it? For good?
I can see about disarming it for you.
Oh, all right. Fine. But listen here. Just take a look at it first. Go easy. If you get the job done, there'll be 100 caps in it for you.
How about 500?
Not an option, I'm afraid. We aren't exactly rolling in cash down here.
Fine.
Great.
I really want 500 caps, but whatever. I know there's multiple ways to do every quest, and I know that I'm going to get hell from you guys in the comments. But, we just got a new quest, I believe. Know anything about the area outside Megaton?
It's called the Wasteland for a reason. But there are settlements, too, spread all around. The human race is stubborn like that. To the south, you've got Rivet City. But don't bother going to DC. The place is a war zone.
I believe it. Oh, hey, I got a map marker. Cool. I'm learning more about the world. I'm not sure I can disarm the bomb. No, that's not true. I will eventually be able to disarm the bomb. Now that I'm helping you, maybe you can help me. I'm looking for my dad.
Well, come to think of it, I do remember a stranger coming through here. Had a look in his eye. You know the kind a man gets when he's got a purpose. Spent some time up in the saloon. Might want to check with Moriarty. Just watch yourself. That man's trouble.
All right, I've heard of the name Moriarty before. I do believe the old woman that I definitely did not kill and definitely found her dead body and stole her stuff. She mentioned. The dead body mentioned Moriarty. I could use some directions around town.
Sure.
I'm looking for, I need some equipment.
Moira sells all kinds of stuff at her place.
Moira.
Crater Side Supply. Take a guess where it is.
It's by the side of the crater. Okay. Let's talk about something else. I want to get the hell out of here.
Good luck. Careful around that bomb.
I will set it off and blow up your entire civilization. Anyway, let's make our way to Crater Side Supply then. I'm curious to see what they have to offer, especially since I stole a bunch of caps from,
You're looking to trade, stranger? Check out Crater Side Supply.
You a spokesperson, or... there's the clinic there. Oh, Crater Side Supply. It's up there. Why is it up there? It said Crater Side. I guess it's on the side of the crater, eh? for some reason, I thought it would be down by the actual bomb. Look at how cool that thing looks. Like, I remember when I showed up at Megaton for the first time playing this game before. Like, this was the town that really kind of... I don't know. It's very homey here. And then you have the bomb, of course. All right, let's go into Crater Side Supply and see what Moira, I guess is her name. See what she's up to. Hey there.
Hey, I hear you're that stray from the vault. Oh, I haven't seen one of you for years.
Good
to meet you. I'm Moira Brown. I run Craterside Supply. But what I really do is mostly tinkering and research. Say, I'm working on a book about the wasteland.
Ooh, is it a novel?
It'd be great to have the foreword by a vault dweller. Help me out, would you?
I would love to. I'm very into reading. I love Grognak the Barbarian. Have you heard of it? Sure, I've got plenty to say about life in the vault.
Great. Just tell me what it's like to live underground all your life, or to come outside for the first time, or whatever strikes your fancy.
It was a paradise down there. No fear, no worries, no fighting until Dad left. That sounds like I don't know. Moira's not exactly my therapist here. This outside place is amazing. In the main room, I can't even see the ceiling.
Yeah, you wouldn't imagine how hard it is to replace that big light bulb up there, too. That's great for a forward. Open with a joke and all that. Here, take the suit. Something tells me you might need it. That'll be good for the book. In fact, want to help me with the research? I can pay you, and it'll be fun.
Okay, so what kind of pay and what kind of work?
Let's see. Dealing with radiation, testing an experimental device, and, I won't lie, it may include some reading.
Oh, God, no, we can't do it. Reading? We can't do it, I'm sorry.
Caps, meds, chems, and maybe even a few of your
That's crossing the line.
If you do a good job. Interested?
We can do radiation, we can do guns and devices that'll probably get me killed, but reading? Maybe I've taken this joke too far. Let's see, sounds good. Tell me more.
It's a dangerous place out there in the wastes, right? People could really use a compilation of good advice, like a wasteland survival guide. For that, I need an assistant to test my theories. I wouldn't want anyone to get hurt because of a mistake. Nobody's ever happy when that happens. No, then they just yell a lot at me with mean, mean words.
I can't imagine why. All right, I guess I'll help with your survival guide.
All right, then. Now, I think the first chapter will have to be about surviving day-to-day dangers. Things like where it is and isn't safe to find food, the dangers of radiation, and how to avoid and even profit from dangerous landmines. Ooh, sounds like fun, doesn't it? Which do you want to do first?
I don't know. I don't know if this is really a necessity, because at this point, it's been a very, very long time, and these people have been living in the wasteland their entire lives. It's just second nature. They learn to adapt without, like, learning how to survive in the wasteland like it's some new thing. But anyway, whatever. I'm not gonna argue it. What's this about radiation? Let's do that one first.
Well, that's what I need your help for, isn't it? I know lots about it from books, but I never seem to get a live example. Not for long, anyway. So I need you to get a bit of radiation poisoning, so I can study its effects.
Really?
Oh, not a deadly dose, of course. I can fix you up before that.
No, I would rather die. You want me to get irradiated? How could that possibly be worth it for me?
Oh, don't worry so much about it. I'll be here waiting with a nice tall glass of rad-cleansing Brahmin milk for you when you get back. Well, mostly just a whole lot of Rad-X and Rad-Away. And maybe even a more reliable way to get rid of radiation. Assuming it works, of course.
Moira, this better be goddamn worth my time, I'm telling you what. I better not get a hideous mutation out of this.
Oh, you're a peach. Or at least some sort of hardy fruit that grows in the savagely irradiated mockery of agriculture we have nowadays. Now, 200 rads should be enough for basic sickness. But if you can get 600 or more rads, my test will be even more accurate. Just make sure you can get back here, and I'll see to it that you're well taken care of.
All right. Here we go. The Wasteland Survival Guide. The first, like, real quest that I'm going to be doing for you guys. I personally, like, before you guys even suggested in the comments, a lot of you suggested doing it in the comments, but I was planning on doing it anyway because this is the quest that I always kind of start off with because it's a good introduction to the Wasteland and what you have to do, and it gives you a lot of loot and experience right off the bat. So I'm going to put my gun away because I don't want to freak people out, but we need to get irradiated now. Oh, God. Do I even want to talk to these people? These people actually worship the bomb. I'm going to come over to the water, though, and actually drink the water. And I was also told if you hold the button... Thank you to those in the comments that commented about this. I'm going to sit here and just drink the radiation. Why not? I now have radiation poison. Visit a doctor. Okay.
Oh, God. Oh, God. I'm going to die. Or become a superhuman. Preferably a superhuman.
Oh, my God. I swear to God, I hear that guy in the background, like, worshipping that bomb, and I just want to kill him every single time. Every single time I want to kill him. Oh, my God. I don't know how I can possibly drink so much. Okay, is that enough? Have I done it? Yes, I did. I got 600 radiation. That does not take long at all. Let's go right back to Moira and see what she has us do next. I figured I'd get the worst one out of the way. Radiation. Blah. Blah. Oh, God. I'm gonna... Blah. Okay. It's all right. It's all right. I'm good. I do believe at some point, like... Well, I didn't read the text on the screen, but it said I got, like, radiation poisoning. And, I used to think that it would have been really cool if, like, you started growing an arm out of your stomach or something. Just kind of funny little morphs.
Oh, feeling a bit under the weather or a bit over the Geiger counter.
That was so funny. I'm about as irritated, I mean, irradiated Freudian slip as I can get without burning a hole in the floor.
I can tell. You're positively glowing.
Oh, no, you misunderstand. That's not the radiation. I'm pregnant.
Tell me how it feels, and I'll get you fixed right up.
You know, it just do your examination, please.
You're a mighty lucky one, you know that? At this state, most people would have trouble standing up, much less walking over here.
Then why did you make me do it?
Let me take notes, and I'll handle that nasty radiation with a bit of my own homemade Radcure concoction. I've never had a chance to test it out on someone so heavily dosed, but I'm sure it'll work out fine. Exciting, isn't it?
If this doesn't work, I will kill you and take everything you have.
A little Brahmin milk, a couple magnets, and maybe a few happy thoughts.
I'm not going to be cured by happy thoughts, Moira.
Well, you're alive. Oh, that's the good news. But there was a little side effect. A teeny tiny, mutation. But it seems to be benign, at least.
What are you talking about?
Here, take a few radiation chems, as my little way of saying, I'm sorry I twisted your DNA like a kitten with a ball of yarn.
Damn it! Moira's experiment has an unexpected side effect. Now you suffer from advanced radiation poisoning. Crippled limbs automatically regenerate. Oh boy! So the mutation was a good thing. So now throughout the game, if I fall off a big cliff or something and break my leg, it'll regenerate itself. So that's my mutation? I'll take it. Thank you, Moira. I'm ready to continue the research to the first chapter. I'm already liking the start of this.
How safe it is to scavenge food from one of those huge stores out there.
Oh, yeah?
I need someone to research how to travel through a minefield. And that'll cover the first section of the book. Which strikes your fancy?
Getting food doesn't sound so bad. What are you looking for?
Well, food and medicine. Everyone needs them once in a while, right? So they need a good place to find them. There's an old super-duper mart not far from here. I need to know if a place like that still has any food or medicine left in it.
All right, let's go to Walmart.
Oh, great. Food is most important, but see if you can get medicine, too. And if there's nothing to find, then just come back in one piece, okay?
Now, if you really wanted to, you can just be like, so... I went to the Super Duper Mart and there was nothing. Sorry. But I'm pretty sure you get a better outcome. What? Shut up. I'm pretty sure there's a better outcome if you actually bring back food and medicine, especially medicine. So I'm going to go. You're really friendly. Good Lord. Everybody's really friendly. So we're going to go on an adventure. This is exciting. This is the most exciting part about it because I actually get to go places and do stuff. First of all, let me mark my actual quest here, because I'm pretty sure the wrong quest is selected. There we go. The Wasteland Survival Guide. One thing I like about this game over other games like it, like Oblivion or Skyrim or Fallout New Vegas, I don't feel completely overwhelmed with quests in this game. I never really have more than maybe 4 or 5 quests at a time. And obviously near the beginning here, we probably won't have a whole lot because I'm just going to get a quest and start doing that and see where it kind of...
I need water.
What? You're dying?
Please. Please help me. I need water.
I'm so sorry. But I really don't care.
I understand. You have to look out for yourself. Just leave me.
Oh, who brought the frickin' pity party? Want me to call the wambulance? Good lord, guy. Just go into Megaton. You look like the rest of them. I walked right up in there, and they offered me all kinds of stuff. But then again, maybe I'm smarter than you. I don't know. All right, anyways, we need to make our way to the Super Duper Mart. Also, I was informed in the comments that the gun that I'm using that I stole off of Silver is terrible, and I should save the ammo. Too bad I used up a lot of ammo already. We'll just use a 10 millimeter pistol for now. Make sure you get that shit out, because you never know what you're going to find out here. Oh my god, look at this. It's all kind of crazy stuff over here. And also bugs. Bloat fly, please die. Here, I'll vats you. I don't know why he's running away. Probably because I'm murdering his face. Where are you going? I'm wasting my ammo right now to kill a bloat fly that's going to give me 1 experience point, but whatever. I do what I want. And obviously, like, I don't know, bloat flies and most animals don't have really anything on them. They tend to be pretty difficult to kill sometimes, too, so it's like, it's a little bit disappointing to go up to their dead corpse and search it for nothing. What is this place? Can I actually do something here? Activate water tower valve. Oh, I guess I drink out of it. Oh, well. Radiation poisoning. Don't mind me. Oh, God, that was a really creepy noise. I actually think I heard a noise that in real life that sounded like it came from the game, like a creaky noise. But maybe it came from the game. I don't know. I heard it out on my left ear, and I don't have a headphone in my left ear. Weird. So is this the Super Duper Mart? This looks like the back of the Super Duper Mart. It also doesn't look that super duper. As a child, I was weirdly fascinated by the backs of stores. I don't know quite why. I just was like, what does the back of the store look like? It doesn't look like anything. It looks like the back of a store. But as a kid, I was fascinated by that for some reason. I was a simple child. This is your friend, John. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. Well, what? I didn't do anything to you. You don't know. I could be a good guy. I could want to, you know, invite you to tea or something. Here, I'm going to get closer so I can vat your face. Literally vats your face. Get a better... Oh, God. I just knocked his head off. Literally knocked his block off. And I'll take your stuff. Oh, I'll take your 10mm pistol. I always take the pistol when I can. Because you can repair your guns. I didn't go over that either. But I'm going to go over that right now. Especially because I need to go in here anyway. And apply my armor. Armored jumpsuit. Let's see here. Damage resistance is 12. Do we have any... Why is the damage resistance on this better than the security armor? I don't know. I'll take it, though. The condition's also better than the security armor. And, I'll just put on my baseball cap. The helmet will give me more damage resistance, but I think it looks stupid. Plus, this puts up my perception by 1 anyway, and I could use that. And, eyeglasses usually put up something. I know in New Vegas, a lot of eyeglasses and whatnot put up your perception by 1. I also have... anyway, what was I saying? Oh, the condition, as you can see there, there's a little bar, and this one's, like, really damaged here. You can repair your guns with that. So I always pick up duplicates of guns to repair other guns. Oh, wow, that's mighty gruesome. Nuka-Cola, always good. Except that it gives you radiation and doesn't give you a whole lot of help, but if you stockpile them throughout the game, they can really, really help you. So this is the Super Duper Mart. I'm going to be really careful because I don't know what's in here because there was a raider outside. You can never tell going into places like this, dungeons and whatnot, whether or not there's going to be people in here. Also, I just got a Nuka-Cola Quantum out of there. I got one in the previous episode too. There is a quest in this game. People pointed it out in the comments, and I remember there being a quest where you're going to need Nuka-Cola Quantum later on. So I'm going to hold on to my Nuka-Cola Oh, there's a guy up there. I'm going to sneak around and steal out of the cash registers. Bobby pins are always nice. And pre-war money. I should have picked up the pre-war money that was in the desk before because you can they're worth a fair amount of money. And you can sell them. They don't weigh anything, and they're worth 10 caps each. So if you want to sell them for... Or sell them to merchants and whatnot. I've also been informed, not informed, but suggested by a lot of people to use... Oh, caution. Oh, I gotta get out of hide. I've been suggested by a lot of people to use... Oh, shit. No, no. Oh, you got a helmet on, too. This isn't gonna go well for me. Shoot your head off. Unless I decide to, you know, decapitate you. Why the hell not? No, I'm not going to take his armor. Don't want your shitty armor. What was I saying? Oh, right. Man, I don't remember what I was saying, actually. Oh, right. Scrap metal. I'm probably going to find some of it. People have suggested I get scrap metal because I can sell it for a fair amount to people. Actually, somebody said it was worth 100 caps each, but it's not. We also got more stealth boys. Oh, those might come in handy for sneaking around. I am going to try and put up my sneak skill throughout the game. I've also been told by a lot of people to use energy weapons. I've never... Like, I used energy weapons in Fallout New Vegas and was a little bit disappointed. And maybe it's better in this game, but I'm going to stick to what I know, which is going to be small guns. And I'll probably put some stuff into big guns so I can blow stuff up because I like blowing things up. I'm gonna be that guy that puts points into sneak and big guns and walks around with a mini nuke launcher and like sneaks around like sneaking up on people with a mini nuke. So did I find food? I'll take the Blammo mac and cheese and Salisbury steak. Squirrel stew, my favorite. But I also wanna get medicine. And this is actually a more challenging part about this little mission, is getting the medicine, because the pharmacy is way in the back. And as you saw already, there's raiders in here, so we need to kind of be a little bit more stealthy about this. I don't see any more guys. There's a whole bunch of these, like, platforms that looks like they're supposed to be walking around on them, but nobody's here. Hello? Hello? Anybody home? This should be my home, except for all of the dead bodies, like, chained to the roof. I don't know what's up with that, but, I'm not sure I approve. Oh, does he see me? Does he see me? He doesn't see me. Oh, I wonder if I can get a sneak attack. Do they have those in this game? I don't really remember. No, 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 nope. They all saw me, and now they're going to kill me. Shoot him, there we go. Vats can be annoying sometimes. I think there's a way, I don't think there's a way to turn off the slow motion. But I used to hate that when we first started playing the game. I first played Fallout 3. I hated Vats. Oh, don't run away. It's a good thing I've got a bunch of stim packs because I'm probably gonna need them here because I am really low leveled right now and not at all prepared to miss. Help. Oh, you've got a freaking assault rifle. That is cheating, sir. Oh, God, he's better than me. Where am I? I need to get my points back. Get my AP up here. They don't know I'm here. Oh, maybe they do. You're really close to me. Ugh. I could pickpocket him in mid-battle. But I'm also going to make sure I keep an eye on my health here, because that's going to be a problem in just a minute. I'm going to die in just a minute. I've got a bunch of Nuka-Cola. Do I want to use those, or do I want to use stim packs? I'll use my stim packs. That's another reason why I want to put up my medicine skill as well. Oh, hey, look, the game froze again. Oh my god, really? It froze again? Shit. Chinese pistol. Chinese pistol, I'll take it. Alright, so here we are again. I'm being shot at again by people with assault rifles. Because I decided to piss off everybody and thought it was a good idea to do such a thing. But it's really not a good idea to anger people with better guns than you. Let's keep that in mind. I would like to shoot this person since she's almost dead. Wow, I am doing next to nothing. But I did decapitate that person, so that's nice. Decapitation's always fun. And using more stim packs than I can afford is also fun. I am really not ready for this. And playing very, very terribly, and everybody's facepalming. Alright, here we go. Oh, die. Oh, there we go. Critical strike. Not bad. That's why I like to put the luck up at the beginning of the game, because I like getting critical strikes that can help you in a dire situation when you are absolutely in need. Please die. Thank you. Now I can pick up your gun. And you had a shotgun, didn't you not? Yes, I love the combat shotgun. Until you get, like, some of the specialty shotguns, near the beginning of the game, the combat shotgun is where it's at, I'm telling you. I'm gonna quick save real fast, since we've been having some problems with freezing. Which, by the way, I'm going to fix after this episode. Some of you gave me suggestions on how I can fix it, and I will definitely take the super-duper pharmacy key and a bottle cap mine and some frag grenades. I'm feeling good about this. Frag grenades really turned me on, by the way. Just thought I'd put that out there. Is there any other guys in here? Let me make sure I get some ammo, at least. Shotgun shells, I'll take that. I'm actually going to equip that shotgun right now. Actually, maybe I'll equip the assault rifle. Why not? I'm gonna take the assault rifle. Because that makes me feel more comfortable. Oh god. I'm horrified. So can we get in here? There's a terminal here, too, and I'll look at that in a moment. But I want to scour the... What is this? This is the pharmacy, correct? I want to scour the pharmacy for loot. This is a big part about this game, too, is just going around and farming all this loot. There we go, grenades. Game froze again. Game fucking froze again. Fucking... Wait a minute, what? I think I should probably get the hell out of here. I think I need to find the medicine and stuff and get the hell out of here. Okay, game, don't freeze when I pick up grenades and a mini nuke and pharmacy supplies. Oh, snap, look at all this stuff. Can I go back to Moira now, please? Oh, God, there's a bunch of stuff here. You know what? I'm going to come back. Oh, my God, there's Nuka-Cola Quantum. Nuka-Cola Quantum for days. And regular Nuka-Cola. I'm sure there's even bottle caps lying around here somewhere, but I don't want to take all my time spent here, especially since I heard somebody come in earlier, and I don't know who's here, or if they're friendly or not. They're probably not friendly. I mean, maybe they were coming here to kill the raiders, and then they found out that the raiders were dead because I killed them. Either way, I do not want to be the person who is here when those people find that I just took some scotch. I'll drink that later to alleviate my fears. Oh, well, maybe it was just more raiders that I heard earlier. There's more of them. Oh my god, are you serious? How did you see me? How did you see me? How did you see me? And where are you even going? Why? What the hell? Alright. Here, let me... Oh, God. Let me at least heal up a little bit. And I will get out my assault rifle. Oh! And murder you. Oh. Here, I'll shoot you in the face with this assault rifle. Oh, wow. That is, powerful. But then it is an assault rifle, after all. Hopefully this is not, like, attracting the other ones. Chinese officer's sword? Really? I'll take it. That's what he was hitting me with? Good God. Do we have any ammo or anything out here? Yeah, you had shotgun shells, because you're the chick that had a shotgun. Now, I need to be really careful getting out of here. Oh, God. Alright, I'm just gonna sneak out of here. I don't need to fight these guys. Especially since I only have 5 bullets left in my assault rifle right now. Don't look this way, don't look this way, don't look this way, don't you look this way. You don't see me here. You don't see me here. You don't see me here. You don't see- You see me! You see me! You don't see me! You don't see me! I'm not here. I'm not here. I'm running. You know what? I'ma just go. I'ma leave now. It's time to go back. It's time to fast travel quickly back to Megaton. So yeah, there is fast travel in this game, and it's not that far, but I'm gonna do it anyway while I still have the chance, because they will chase me out of that door. And I just want to go back to Moira and end this, because I've had so much trouble with freezing in this episode that I really, really just want to end the episode so I can fix it. That's it. That's all I can say. Moira, I have your stuff. Oh, it's the middle of the night. You know what? In the next episode, we'll talk to Moira and finish up this part of the quest. There's a lot more to go, a lot more to see. Thank you to everybody who told me about how I can fix the freezing issue in the comments of the previous video. I will actually do it come next episode, so hopefully that will work out. Thank you guys for watching. If you like this video, please hit like. If you really enjoyed this content and you haven't done it already, please consider subscribing. I've been Josh Jepson, and I will see you in the next one.